Well, like I said in another broadcast, I studied with some Mormons once, and they said to pray about the Book of Mormon. I did, and I got the feeling, but then I didn't become a Mormon because of what I knew. I knew it was nonsense.
All right, so I'd say your methodology is consistent with mine to some extent, in that you took that experience and you processed it in as a piece of data within the broader context of more data, and you came to the determination that it was a false experience.
But it's a real experience. It's something I really felt. I had to disallow it. I had to say, like, in the court of my mind, that is not allowed because it doesn't.
Right. So I misspoke, actually. Not a false experience. That's not the best way to say that. It was not the source of that experience was not what it was purported to be. Is that fair?
No, I think it was a valid. Who knows what the source is? I mean, the source of your experience could be invalid too. I don't know about the source. In fact, I think you know, the brain, it's some kind of a trick where the brain manufactured it. So, to me, I got, on one hand, I have an experience. On the other hand, I've got knowledge, and I had to say these are conflicting, but I have to go with the knowledge. There's no way I could throw away the knowledge based on the experience. What's that?
But your knowledge is made up of other experiences.
The knowledge is based on logic and facts, not experiences.
Well, but the fact of the matter is you had that experience. I mean, epistemologically, a posteriori knowledge is empirical evidence based on some kind of sense experience. Right?
Now, No, I would say it's based on logic, like deduction and induction.
No, that would be a priori.
But it's not feelings. It's not feelings at all. It's the logic and feelings are two. To me, they're two different things. They're at odds.
Do you understand the difference between non-empirical and empirical data, though? Like, there's pure reason, and then there's the ability to experience things, and that can be experiencing that one apple plus one apple equals two apples. You can experience that, but there's a difference between that and pure reason.
No, but I wouldn't say that's really. I wouldn't call that an experience. I mean, that's not a feeling kind of thing to say there's one apple plus one apple. I mean, that's an observation, not a feeling.
But you're using your senses to experience that. You're using your sight instead of your sensation of touch.
Right, right. Yeah, but you're not going by your feelings where you say, I know this is true because I feel it in my heart. I mean, that's the totally different thing.
But that's not what you felt either. You felt a sensory experience, correct?
I felt the touch of God.
In reading the Book of Mormon.
The Mormons would say, hey, that was God. He spoke to you just like he spoke to us. We all have that burning in the bosom. That's it. Amen. And it's like, I can't accept that because I got the feeling, but I just can't accept that it's valid because it doesn't make sense. They might say, like, well, it doesn't have to make sense. Just go with your feelings. And I would say, no, sorry. I'm going with what makes logical sense, not what. I can't go with the feelings.
And what I'm saying is, I think we're looking at this probably closer than you realize it. And so far as what I'm saying is, well, you may be totally discounting that experience. I would suggest that experience should be considered within the picture of larger amounts of data, which is what you ended up doing, was you looked at, I have all of this information, and I have new information. Your new information is I had this experience. Mm-hmm. This new information contradicts this other information, so I'm going to interpret this experience, this new information of experience, through the lens of this other data I have, which I would say is the correct thing to do. I think you did the right thing there. But the only thing I think we would differ on, maybe, is I would not maybe just as so quickly disregard that experience. I might suggest that, I'd say there's two possibilities from that. One is some kind of, I don't know, hyper placebo effect, where you just had this, something like that occur on maybe on more of a naturalistic perspective. Or I could say maybe you had a really genuine religious experience with that, and I can say that as a Christian, and that doesn't contradict my belief system, that you could still have a genuine experience there.
Okay, well, so we're way over time and we're out of time. We're going to get kicked out of the studio soon. I'll give you 30 seconds to summarize the whole program, and then we'll say goodbye.